Hi everyone, welcome back to another video from Tech Basics. In this video, we are going to be learning how to use Zoom application on laptops for beginners. If you are new to Zoom and you'd like to know how you can get used to it, and if you'd like to know how you can get started with the platform, then the process is quite easy. So let's jump into the video right away. First of all, you will need to download and install Zoom on your laptop. Step 1. Download and install Zoom. To download and install Zoom on your laptop, first of all, make sure to open up a web browser. Go to the URL box and type in zoom.us and search. Soon after you do that, you will end up in the official website for Zoom. From the official website, scroll all the way down and under Downloads, click on Zoom Desktop Client. Now, click on the download link right under Zoom Desktop Client, and then you will then be able to download the Zoom installer file. Once the installer file has been downloaded, click on Open File. You will then be able to see that the Zoom application is now initializing. Follow through the on-screen instructions and install Zoom application for your laptop. Step 2. Launch Open Zoom. Once the installation is done, you will then be able to see the interface where you have three options. You can join into an existing meeting without signing up or signing in by simply clicking on Join a Meeting. Enter the meeting ID or the personal link name that has been shared with you by your client. If you want to sign up and get started with Zoom, click on the Sign Up button. Now, follow through the sign up process. Signing up for Zoom. In order to sign up for Zoom, you will first need to confirm your birth year. Once you are done with it, click on Continue and enter the rest of the information such as email address and click Continue. You will also need to verify your email. Open up your email inbox. You can also click on this email links and you will then be able to find the verification code in it. Click open the email from Zoom that you received and then enter the verification code that you received. After you are done, you will then be able to get to the main homepage for Zoom. Step 4. Adjusting video and audio settings. Now that you have created your account, the next step is to test your audio and video settings before joining a meeting. Click on the gear button at the top right corner of your home screen and select audio from the list in order to choose your microphone and speaker options. Similarly, select video and adjust your video settings from the options. Similarly, you can also customize other settings from this screen. Step 5. Joining a meeting. To join into a meeting, you will need to click on the Join button from the main homepage. Now enter a meeting ID or personal link name that you've been shared with. You also have an option to change your name on the screen. You can change to a different name if you wish. If you don't want to connect to audio or if you don't want to turn on your video, you can simply make adjustments here by clicking on the boxes. Finally, click on Join and you will be able to enter the meeting room that you have been invited to. Step 6. Meeting controls. Once in a meeting, familiarize yourself with meeting controls at the bottom of the screen. You can use the microphone icon and mute and unmute your audio. You can use the start video option in order to enable or disable videos for your meeting. The security option will let you manage who can get access to the rooms and other participation settings you can allow or not. And when it comes to participation settings, you can use the participation option in order to see who else is in the meeting and manage the participants. You can also manage participants by sending them invitation link. To add person on your meeting, click on invite and then select a contact or enter an email address. You can also choose from the list of your contacts or simply copy your invite link and share it with your friends from any other platform. Once they join in with your invitation link, they will appear in the participants list on the right hand corner. You can also use other options like sharing screen. You can use the share screen button to share your screen with others in your meeting. Step 7. Leaving a meeting. If you want to leave a meeting after you are done, When the meeting is over, click on the end button in red. Now click on either leave meeting, or if you want to end up the meeting for every participant since you are the host, click on end meeting for all. Soon after you do that, you will be able to end your meeting on Zoom. Apart from that, you can also create a new meeting, be a host on Zoom, schedule a meeting, or simply share your screen by using the share screen option on Zoom. So those were some of the steps you can simply learn in order to use Zoom application on your laptop. With these steps, you can join and host meetings, collaborate with others, and stay connected from anywhere at any time. If the video was helpful to you, go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel by hitting the subscribe button. Also, press on the notification bell so that you'll never miss another upcoming upload from us. I will be back again in the next video. Thank you for watching.